السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يوم لا يخزي الله النبي والذين آمنوا معه، نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector and curer. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. O slaves of Allah, first and foremost, I enjoin upon myself and then all of you all who have come here to adopt a life of taqwa. For it is only through a life of taqwa, that is to bring in the consciousness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can a slave of Allah attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. May Allah the Almighty make us all from the people of taqwa. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, inshallah ta'ala, today's khutbah is going to evolve around an extremely important element, an element which is missing in all of our lives, an element which most of us have many misconceptions about, and that is in regard to at-tawbah. Most of us have this understanding of tawbah, that we think that tawbah is something which is reserved for sinners, or else that tawbah is a concept which is reserved for the month of Ramadan, or it is something that the minute I commit a sin, only then do I have to practice tawbah. What is tawbah? Tawbah, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in its literal sense, what it means is a rujoo' in the Arabic language, and that means to turn back. So scholars say a tawbah is to turn away from all those things that displease our beloved Maker and to turn towards Him and those actions that would win over His pleasure. This is what tawbah is. And my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, there are many ayat in the noble Quran. Likewise, there are many ahadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that highlight the importance of tawbah. That highlight the importance of tawbah being part and parcel of every believer's daily life. This is how important a tawbah is. And basically you could translate it in English to repentance. This is how important repentance is for a believer, for a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty, He says in the noble Quran,
وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ.
O believers, توبوا إلى الله, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, جَمِيعًا, all of you all, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you all will attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He did not address us as saying, O sinners, O "Oh, the ones who have oppressed yourselves, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Oh, believers," not even "Ya Muslimun," "Ya Mu'minun," "Ayyuhal Mu'minun," "Oh, believers, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tawbah." Now this is how important. Even the mu'minun, the believers, have to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tawbah. Likewise, the ayah I recited in the beginning, "Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha." O you who believe, once again, O you the ones who have brought in iman, tubu ila Allah, turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Turn to Allah in repentance, tawbatan nasuha, a sincere, a pure repentance. Allahu Akbar. Look at the statement of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, who says, "أكثر الناس لا يعرفون قدر التوبة ولا حقيقتها." الله أكبر. أكثر الناس لا يعرفون قدر التوبة ولا حقيقتها فضلا عن القيام بها علما وعملا وحالا. Most of mankind do not know the reality of tawbah, nor do they know the value of tawbah, leave alone establishing it in their lives. This is the statement of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. For most of us, we have misunderstood the concept of tawbah, and that is why we fail to make it part and parcel of our everyday lives. Look at the hadith of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This hadith is recorded in Bukhari and other books. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addresses the sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, "Ya ayyuhan nas, Ya ayyuhan nas, istaghfiru rabbakum wa tubu ilayh." O people, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tawbah. "Fa'inni astaghfirullaha wa atubu ilayhi fi kulli yawmin mi'ata marra." For I myself, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, I seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I make tawbah. I turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance more than 100 times for every single day. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Ghafar Allahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi wa ma ta'akhkhar." All of his past and future sins have been forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He makes tawbah, he seeks forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 100 times every single day. Have any of us got the guarantee that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven all of our sins, our past and our future sins? Then how many times do we have to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And this Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is doing it every single day. Allahu Akbar. Every single day. For my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the whole of deen, the whole of Islam is incorporated within the concept of tawbah. The first part of the statement of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, before the one I mentioned in the beginning, he says, "At-tawbatu hiya haqiqatu deen al-Islam." Allahu Akbar. Words that deserve to be inscribed in gold. "At-tawbatu hiya haqiqatu deen al-Islam. Fad-deenu kulluhu dakhilun fi musamma at-tawbah." That The whole of deen, that is the reality of a tawbah. And Islam, iman, ihsan, all of this, the whole deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is incorporated within a tawbah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Allah the Almighty, He is waiting for us to turn to Him, and no sin is too great for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive. Allahu Akbar. If a slave of Allah thinks that his sin that he has committed is too great for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive, that thought alone of his needs another tawbah. That thought alone of his is a greater sin than the sin he has committed. For no sin, let it be murder, let it be any sin, let it even be shirk, let it even be kufr. The minute a slave of Allah removes the robes of shirk and kufr, rejecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, associating partners unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the minute a slave of his removes all of these robes at the doorstep of iman and tawheed, our beloved maker Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting to accept that slave of his. Allahu Akbar. Look at this amazing hadith Qudsi. And I think all of you are aware what is a hadith Qudsi. A hadith Qudsi is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrated through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but it is not considered the Quran, rather it is from the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu narrates, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله. The Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is reported to have said that Allah the Almighty is addressing us. Amazing, beautiful hadith. يبنى آدم. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is addressing each and every one of us. O son of Adam, إنك ما دعوتني ورجوتني غفرت لك على ما كان فيك ولا أبالي. As long as you pray unto me, as long as you invocate unto me, as long as you supplicate unto me, ورجوتني, and as long as you have hope in me, غفرت لك على ما كان فيك ولا أبالي. I will forgive all of your sins and I will not even look back at those sins. Allahu Akbar. Hadith goes on. يبنى آدم, O son of Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. O son of Adam, even if your sins were to reach the heavens, Allahu Akbar, even if you were to come with mountains of sins, ثم استغفرتني, and then you seek forgiveness from me, غفرت لك ولا أبالي. I will forgive all of your sins and I will not even look back at those sins. ولا أبالي. I will not even care about those sins. Allahu Akbar. The hadith does not end. يبنى آدم. إنك لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني ولا تشرك بي شيئا لأتيتك بقرابها مغفرة. الله أكبر. O son of Adam, even if you were to come to me with sins equivalent to this whole planet, with sins equivalent to this whole planet, but you meet me in a state where you do not associate partners unto me, you believe firmly in me alone, I will come to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our beloved maker, he's saying, I will come to you with a forgiveness equivalent to your sins to match your sins, Allahu Akbar. I will come with a forgiveness equivalent to this planet. Look at how forgiving our beloved maker, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, this hadith is recorded in Tirmidhi and class Sahih by Imam Ibn al-Qayyim and Imam al-Bani, rahimahumullah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, like I said in the beginning, it is not upon us to lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not upon us to despair in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to have firm and strong hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Allah the Almighty is waiting to forgive all of our sins. But it is upon us to take the initiative. It is upon us to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He is waiting to forgive us. He's waiting. Let me end the khutbah with an incident. This, historians mentioned this incident. It is a beautiful incident in regard to the tawbah of a sahabi radiallahu anhu. It is mentioned in the Sabab al-Nuzul of an ayah. The ayah I will mention as we go on. This is the story of Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu. Abu Lubaba. This, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, this incident took place right after the battle of Khandaq, the battle of the trenches. Now this particular battle took place in Medina, and the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in, they dug trenches in front of Medina to protect the front of Medina. And there was an agreement between a Jewish tribe known as Banu Qurayza. There was an agreement between Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Muslim army, and that particular tribe, that they would look after the behind of Medina, where the women folk were. Now what happened in that particular battle, Banu Qurayza, they breached that agreement between Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They let in a few enemy soldiers slip within the barracks and attack the people of Medina from behind. So right after the battle, they knew that they had breached the agreement. All of them, they rushed into a particular fortress and they besieged, in the sense they took refuge in that particular fortress. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Muslim army, besieged Banu Qurayza in that particular fortress. Banu Qurayza refused to come out, and they were in there for some time. As long as they had rations with them, food and water, they stayed in that particular fortress. Now the minute they ran out of rations, the minute they ran out of water and food, they wanted to come up with some negotiations. Now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam sent Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu as an ambassador. He sent him to talk on behalf of the Muslim army, the reason being he had previous links with Banu Qurayza. He was in good terms with Banu Qurayza. Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu enters the fortress. The minute he enters the fortress, Banu Qurayza, the whole tribe come rushing to Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu. Ya Aba Lubaba, Ya Aba Lubaba, tell us, what are we to do? Now Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu immediately conveys the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you all are supposed to stop all of this nonsense and come out and surrender to the Muslim army. Now whilst he passed the message, the women folk came rushing to him, Ya Aba Lubaba, you tell us sincerely, what is going to happen outside there? Now Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu did something on his own accord. He signaled like this. He did not utter a word. And for the people who cannot see me, he just ran his hand over his neck. And all of us know what that signifies. He indicated that if you all come out, it is going to be a massacre outside there. Now this, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, stirred up a lot of commotion amongst Banu Qurayza. There was a lot of fitna which arose due to that particular indication. Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu comes rushing out of the fortress, and he's feeling bad. He's feeling really bad now. He rushes to Masjidun Nabawi. He knows what he has done is wrong. He has betrayed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He has gone against the ayah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la takhunu Allah wal Rasul. O you who believe, do not try to deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nor his beloved messenger. He knows he has betrayed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He rushes to Masjidun Nabawi. He goes to a particular pillar and he ties himself up on the pillar. He ties himself up on the pillar. And the pillar is known even until today, even though I doubt that there would be traces to identify the pillar, it is known as Istiwanatul Tawbah, or the pillar of Tawbah. But don't think of buying a ticket and perhaps going and tying yourselves up on that pillar. That was only for that Sahabi radiallahu anhu. He ties himself up on the pillar and he announces that until Allah the Almighty reveals an ayah that I have been forgiven, I am not going to untie myself from this pillar except for salah and food. As no one is exempted from the five obligatory salawat. The news goes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam keeps quiet about it, because now the Sahabi radiallahu anhu is waiting for the decree from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Historians mention that 6 nights pass. His wife used to come and untie him for the obligatory salawat and for him to consume food, and then he would go back and tie himself up around that pillar. 6 nights pass. The 7th morning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam wakes up with a smile. Allahu Akbar. His wife radiallahu anha, who was with him, asks him, Ya Rasulullah, what makes you smile so beautifully? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed an ayah in regard to Abu Lubaba. Allahu Akbar.
وآخرون اعترفوا بذنوبهم خلطوا عملا صالحا وآخر سيئا عسى الله أن يتوب عليهم إن الله غفور رحيم.
الله. The wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam asks Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, can I go and inform Abu Lubaba of the good news? And this could have been before the ayat of covering for women had come down. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam permits her and she rushes to the masjid. Ya Aba Lubaba, Ya Aba Lubaba, an ayah has come down in regard to you. Wa akharuna i'tarafu bidhunubihim, and they are those who have acknowledged their sins. Bidhunubihim khalatu amalan salihan wa akhara sayya, they mixed up a good deed with a bad deed. He went to fulfill the responsibility that he was entrusted by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, an extremely good deed, but he mixed it up with a bad deed. عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perhaps He will forgive him. Allahu Akbar. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This Sahabi radiallahu anhu says, I am not going to untie myself until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself comes and unties me with his blessed hands. Allahu Akbar. Fajr Salah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes to the masjid and unties Abu Lubaba radiallahu anhu. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the only purpose behind me mentioning this beautiful incident is to highlight that none of us have the right to lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's mercy is vast. We are basically wallowing in an ocean of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not give up hope. Do not despair in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He, Allah the Almighty, is waiting for us to turn to Him in sincere tawbah. The final note, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, turn to Him before it's too late. Two conditions. Number one, before Malakul Maut comes and stands in front